Hi there, I'm Ruben for Sonokinetic, and in this video I'll be taking a detailed look at Sonokinetic's Ostinato Strings. Before you watch this video, I'd advise you to spend just 5 minutes watching the short overview video to get an idea of the concept behind Ostinato and some of the basic functions. In this video, I'll be diving into the specifics of the functions rather than showing off the sound. So let's get to it. This is the main interface of Ostinato Strings, and the first thing I want to point out is the help screen, which you can access by clicking just here. This shows what most of the controls do. So before I look at playing Ostinato, I want to show you the options screen as well, which can be found by clicking just here. In this screen, you can adjust global parameters. The string phrases here are comprised of 3 different layers, so you've got 1 low and 2 high. You can adjust the overall volume and panning of each layer by using these sliders. These ones are for volume, and these ones for panning. Command Control click to reset these to default. The global mic options can be found by clicking here. We recorded Ostinato Strings in the same hall as all other Sonokinetic orchestral libraries, so the 4 microphone positions are exactly the same: close, decatry, wide, and far. You can select just one position, or you can choose 2 and use this slider to mix between them. Just be aware that adding a microphone position will double the RAM footprint of Ostinato, so if your system is struggling at all, you might want to consider using the pre-mixed Tutti patch, which is a combination of all the mic positions, and this comes supplied with your download. This section is for setting harmonic shift chords, I'll come back to that later. And lastly, you can set the global tuning of Ostinato just here, from 436Hz to 444. And this function can be useful for matching the tuning of Ostinato to live sessions. A quick look now at the theory behind Ostinato and how the instrument actually works. In the recording sessions, we recorded hundreds of different 2-note intervals in several different patterns with both low and high strings, and we recorded those separately. So each sample is 2 notes playing together in an interval. Then we scripted the Ostinato engine to play the correct combination of intervals for each type of chord and its voicing. So that means there are usually 3 layers of samples playing together, 1 low string layer to provide the bass line, and 2 high string layers to create a chord. The chord is displayed just here, and the notes shown above just here. This is the low string bass part, and this shows the 2 high string parts. These graphics will change depending on the voicings and a whole bunch of other factors. Even though everything was recorded at 130 BPM, the engine tempo syncs the samples to the speed of your project, putting the samples into half or double time if necessary. Because there are 3 different layers playing together, that means that you've got so much flexibility to mute and unmute them, fade them in and out, and change patterns. And this can all be done within the interface by clicking the relevant controls, or much more fun, on the fly with the key switches. You can see where the key switches are by looking at the virtual keyboard on the interface, or there's a full list in the manual. So you see here where it says MIDI C3, that's the C of that octave, and you've got the different bass patterns on the white keys. The black keys are the key switches for various functions, which I'll look at in a minute. It's the same above, with MIDI C4 being the start of the different high string patterns on the white keys. And the black keys being key switches for the 5 different voicings. Again, I'll cover chord voicings in a second. So let's look at how to play Ostinato Strings. If you're familiar with any of Sonokinetic's phrase-based libraries, you'll already know how to play chords on the blue key range just here. Just play a triad or 4 keys, recognised in all inversions, and there are 12 different chord types that are recognised, not just major and minor triads. For a full rundown of the different chord types and how to play them, check the Ostinato manual, but I'll show you a few here. Major, minor, 7th variations, suspended seconds, and fourths, diminished, half diminished, and augmented. You can sustain chords by holding down any number of the keys or by using the sustain pedal. See here on the interface, which will display which chord you're playing and the notes used for that voicing. You can also see the inversion displayed here. If you want to queue up a new inversion, you can use the four key switches at the bottom of the keyboard just here. All you need to do is hit one and then trigger a chord, and that will force that inversion, useful for adding variety to your playback. The specific pattern that is played is shown on the virtual keyboard in orange, and this can be changed by clicking the upper part of the key or by using the key switches in the yellow coloured key ranges here and here. The bottom range from C3 is for the low strings and from C4 for the high strings. By default, the low and high string patterns are locked together, but you can unlock these using this arrow and play different patterns with high and low strings. That arrow also has a key switch here on C-sharp 3, with on and off controlled by velocity. I'll just demo a little bit of playback with some real-time switching. You can also purge and reload individual patterns from RAM by clicking the lower part of the note graphic. Normally the engine will choose the best tempo for the phrases, automatically syncing to your DAW's host tempo. That's the ITM option shown here. However, you can switch the phrases into half or double time, or lock to the original tempo by clicking here, or you can also use key switch D-sharp 3 at various velocities for the four different options. Mute and unmute the three string layers with these three buttons, also on key switches F-sharp 3, G-sharp 3 and A-sharp 3, controlled by high and low velocity. You can create some really interesting patterns by switching the three layers in and out as you play. You've also got mod wheel volume control over the high and low layers. Controls for that are just here, and it's turned on by default, but can be switched off for one or both. There are key switches for these at C-sharp 6 and D-sharp 6. This function allows you to automate the volume of one layer against another. There's also some subtle EQ work going on here to soften the timbre of the layers as the volume is decreased. There are five available chord voicings, which are shown on the virtual keyboard here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, which is a more tense voicing with extensions. Like everything else, these can be switched on the fly as you play using key switches on the black keys in the C4 octave. See how the notes in the interface change as I play. This bass invert function is really interesting. Normally the bass strings will play the root note of whatever chord is detected, regardless of the played inversion. However, with bass invert turned on, it will follow the lowest note of your played inversion. This can create some lovely voice leading effects in the low strings. I'll quickly mention this accent key at B3. Press this key whilst a phrase is playing to add a slight accent to the playback, useful for giving extra emphasis to the downbeat, for example. The harmonic shift function of Ostinato Strings is a little bit different to what you might be used to. It's almost like a one-key automatic voice leading tool and has some extraordinary creative possibilities. Very useful if you're stuck in a composing rut. Play a root chord in the blue key range in the normal way, and then use the green harmonic shift keys to play related chords. These will trigger when you play just the green keys, leaving your other hand free to change patterns or play other key switches. Playing it this way, the instrument will automatically pick inversions and chord types in an intelligent way, and it makes fast chord transitions a breeze. There are two different harmonic shift modes, absolute and relative, and you can switch between those here. So let's look at these separately, and I'll explain what the differences are. Playing the harmonic shift intervals in the green key range here will play chords that are in the same scale and will musically relate to the chord that you last played in the blue key range. Absolute mode will play a chord as played on the green key, So for example, if you press the harmonic key switch A, then you'll get an A chord. So here I've played G major as my starting chord in the left hand, and my absolute harmonic shift played on A will be A minor. If I play E major as my starting chord in the left hand, and play harmonic shift of A again, then this time this will be A major, as it relates to the E major. Play D major as a starting chord, and the A harmonic shift becomes an A seventh. As you can see, if you play A in absolute mode, the harmonic shift will always play a type of A chord in this case, but the type of chord that sounds most musical, based on what type of starting chord is being played by the left hand in the blue key range. Relative mode gives an interval relative to the root chord, so playing A in this case will trigger the major sixth chord of the key selected in the chord area. So you can hear the same interval with different starting chords. Regardless of the harmonic shift mode you choose, the chord types played will be based on the intervals you specify in the harmonic shift area of the options menu. Here you can choose which type of chord is triggered when you play different combinations of chord types and press different harmonic shift keys. For instance, the flat second interval of a major chord is set to half diminished by default, but you might want a dominant seventh, or a major seventh chord, and you can set those here. There's far more information about the specifics of harmonic shift in the Ostinato manual, but by far the most fun way is just to experiment and try the interesting chord combinations thrown up by the engine. Lastly, these two key switches control the phrase continue and bar sync functions, useful for starting phrases on the offbeat, for example. There's more about this in the Ostinato manual. Don't forget that you can always get more information right in the interface by clicking the info button. And for even more information on all the features of Ostinato Strings, head to www.sonokinetic.net, where you can download the manual, listen to demos, and watch more videos. You can also access our knowledge base at support.sonokinetic.net. And thanks so much for watching.